Imagine being in fifth grade and all of a sudden going suddenly deaf in your left ear. Imagine for years after that, suffering from chronic sinusitis, chronic tonsillitis, a variety of medications, seeing many physicians, and never getting to the bottom of what really was going on. That was my life for over 20 years.
Tara was almost resigned to a life of endless health issues, but then she met a doctor who specialized in solving just this kind of mystery.
I heard a lot about Hopkins. Someone recommended I see Dr. Lippincott, who is a specialist here, and he recommended that I see an immunologist named Dr. Antoine Azar.
Hi.
Nice to see you.
So Tara came to see me about 2 years ago. She did not have very frequent infections, but when she did get infections, they were very severe. For someone who's been sick for years and years and years to try to figure out what's been going on and how to approach it, what are the best tests to diagnose. The immune system is very, very broad. There are so many different components that you need to check and look into and so on. So it takes quite an extensive time to get an evaluation done for these patients.
We make advances chiefly when great doctors and passionate patients with rare diseases come together. And with that combination, we end up learning something about the biology. And usually that also leads us to discover that the disease we thought was really rare isn't quite so rare.
Finally, the diagnosis. Adult Primary Immunodeficiency. It's a disease caused by genetic abnormalities in your immune system, an imbalance between the bacteria in your body and the bacteria in the environment outside of your body.
We live with bacteria and different kind of microorganisms everywhere around us, in the soil, and whenever we touch stuff, there's stuff everywhere. But most of us do very well with that and we don't get sick. But if we do not have a good immune system or an immunodeficiency, that's where we no longer can have this normal, balanced relationship. But part of this misconception is that people don't think much about an immune deficiency when there's an adult patient coming with frequent illnesses and infections and so on. And because of that, there's a significant delay in having these patients diagnosed. On average, some patients wait for about 9 years and even more before finally somebody makes a diagnosis of an immune deficiency.
By the time people have come here, they're exhausted and or have seen so many specialists, and they are coming here just praying that it's the right place to be. Everyone wants an extremely intelligent physician, that's a given, but to find someone who genuinely cares and is kind and listens is a whole other aspect of healthcare, much harder to find, and really rewarding to be a part of his team.
I got a chance to ask him about all of the questions that I've had, which was the first time I'd ever met a physician that could put some of these puzzle pieces together.
If you have adult immunodeficiency, there are very few places in the world that have the expertise to evaluate you, diagnose you properly, and treat you properly. And there are even fewer places that have the capacity to bring other scientists in to ultimately shine a light on the biology of this problem. The possibility of curing these diseases is a really big deal.
It's something that I think healthy people take for granted. To day in and day out, know that I'm gonna wake up and I'm gonna be feeling okay to be able to go out into the world. That's amazing.